I got into brewing in 2005. My wife bought me a homebrew kit while we were living in Perth. I brewed my first lager in 35 degree Perth heat without any kind of cooling. So naturally the beer was pretty shit, but I liked it anyways. Eventually the hobby took over and me and Monique, my wife, decided to start our own brewing business. So to do that, I looked for an internship as a brewer. Found one at a Renaissance Brewing down in Blenheim. Supposed to be there for about 3 months, but we ended up staying for 5 years. We quite quickly realized that starting a brewery from scratch, especially back then in 2008, 2009, with the global financial crisis, was gonna be quite a challenge, both logistically and financially. So we decided to contract brew at Renaissance. Renaissance had spare capacity. I kept working there as a brewer for a couple of years. And when they weren't using their tanks, I would use them for the 8 white beers. So we ended up contract brewing for about 5 years, both at Renaissance and at a few other breweries around the country. It was always in the back of our mind that we needed to build our own brewery, and in 2014, we finally hit the go button on that project. We decided to move up to Warkworth here, mainly for family reasons. We didn't have any family down in the South Island, so this seemed like a good place. The brewery that we have here in Warkworth is custom made for our process. The vessels are sized to fit the kind of beers that we're making. So it's a 2,500 liter brewery setup. We don't brew most beers, so around 5,000 liters per batch. We make a wide variety of beers. We started out making big American-inspired beers, big IPAs, big stouts, and so forth. The main reason why we did that back then was simply the fact that you couldn't get those kind of beers in New Zealand, and that's what we wanted to drink. Later on, we've expanded into a large range of sour beers, mainly from the barrels that we have here behind us. We have around 200 wine barrels, 200 used wine barrels, and 7 fruiters. So our total wood capacity is probably about 70,000 liters at the moment. I believe it is still the largest barrel aging program in the Southern Hemisphere. So all in all, we got more wood capacity than we have stainless capacity. At any given time, we have more beer aging in wood than we have fermenting in stainless. Doesn't mean that we make more wood-aged beer than we do stainless fermented beer, because obviously a stainless beer can turn over in 3 weeks. These barrels take more like 3 years to mature. So it's still a very small proportion of our sales, but yeah, it's probably the most fun part of it. We're working at the moment at building a barrel hall out in Matakana wine country. We've got some land, but it's still a big process in getting the building built and getting that up and running. It would have an aspect of hospitality as well, a small tasting room, things like that. I think we've been quite fortunate to be well received both by professional competitions and the consumer alike. We won a champion brewery, a New Zealand champion brewery in 2011, 2 years after we started the brewery, so that's pretty cool. At the same time, we've been on redbeer.com's best 100 breweries in the world list, 4 years running. We're the only Southern Hemisphere brewery on that list. And still to this day, I don't think any Southern Hemisphere brewery has been on there. So unofficially, I'll claim that according to Redbeer, we're the best brewery in the Southern Hemisphere. So we started making sours just for the same reason as we started making all the other beers that we made in the beginning, mainly that we just couldn't get them here. I've tried a lot of sour beers overseas and I really enjoyed drinking them, so naturally the geek inside of me wanted to make them as well. So that's how we started. We started out with just 9 barrels that we bought from Epic Brewing Company. We made that beer and a couple of other beers in those barrels, and then slowly started scaling up in the beginning, another 10 barrels here, another 10 barrels there. About 3 years ago, we really went all in and really started acquiring a lot of barrels. So yeah, we got up to about 200-250 barrels at one point of all sorts of different kind of sour beers. We make a Fijoa beer every year that's quite popular and tasty. Another variety of classic lambic styles, classic Flanders red, and any color in between. We sell our beer pretty much all over the world. We export to 12 different countries at the moment, I believe, maybe 15. Export is a large part of our business, about 40%. But yeah, New Zealand is by far still the biggest market for sure. And in New Zealand, you can get the beer at most New World's, liquor lands, good beer bars around the country. And it is relatively widely available, but still a niche, obviously. But yeah, definitely go find one and try it.